everyone, this is David Watson from Plain Truth, a Holy Spirited podcast with another Plain Truth short, this time on John Wesley and the importance of the whole Bible. In his explanatory notes upon the New Testament, John Wesley wrote, "The scripture, therefore, of the Old and New Testament is a most solid and precious system of divine truth. Every part thereof is worthy of God, and all together are one entire body, wherein is no defect, no excess." Wesley believed that the whole Bible, not just parts of it, were inspired by God. He understood the Bible properly to consist of the 66 books of the Protestant canon. While the King James Version, which Wesley used, did contain the Apocrypha in a separate section, Wesley did not consider the works of the Apocrypha to be scriptural, and as a result, he never preached a sermon from one of them. Article 5 of the Methodist Articles of Religion sets the contours of the Bible for Methodists and excludes all the works of the Apocrypha, or as some other Christian traditions term them, the deuterocanonical books. Wesley believed it was important to read and preach from both the Old and New Testaments. He wrote explanatory notes upon both the Old and New Testaments, and he instructed the people called Methodists to read from both Testaments every day. He warned against neglect of the Old Testament, and he perceived that one cannot understand the significance of God's saving work in Jesus Christ apart from the Old Testament. He believed that above all other knowledge that a minister must have, a knowledge of the whole Bible was most important. "One must know all of the scriptures," he writes, "since one part fixes the sense of another." In other words, the different parts of the Bible illuminate one another, and a lack of scriptural knowledge was likely to lead to misinterpretation. To be clear, Wesley did not understand every part of the Bible to be equally significant. Rather, he believed that there were certain parts of the Bible that more clearly showed the interpretive lens through which one should read the entire Bible. We have 13 sermons of Wesley on the Sermon on the Mount. He also preached frequently from the letter to the Hebrews. 1 John and Romans were also very significant for his understanding of salvation. Each of these works contributed in important ways to a concept we talked about last week, the analogy of faith. The analogy of faith is simply a basic understanding of the core content of the Christian witness. While many biblical scholars today might see one's faith commitments as a hindrance for responsible biblical interpretation, for Wesley, they were essential. Reading the whole Bible as a Christian for the purpose of leading people into new life in Jesus Christ was essential for a proper interpretation of the works of Scripture. Many people don't know that Wesley wrote a book called The Complete English Dictionary. Like his explanatory notes upon the Old and New Testaments, he wrote it for the purpose of helping people understand the Bible. There is, of course, an entry for Methodist in his dictionary, which he defines as one that lives according to the method laid down in the Bible. For Wesley, the Bible was most definitely a canon. That's a Greek word that means rule or measuring rod. The goal of raising up Methodist preachers was, as he put it, to reform the nation, particularly the church, and to spread scriptural holiness over the land. Scriptural holiness, that's a key concept for Wesley. Without the Bible, the whole Bible, we wouldn't know who God is, who and what we are as human beings, our need for salvation, or the way to be saved. We might have some vague sense of a greater power out there, but we wouldn't have the crucial divine revelation that shows us how to live and believe in ways that will draw us ever closer to the God who has come to us in Jesus Christ. If you'd like to learn more about these topics, I recommend 3 essays in the book Wesley, Wesleyans, and Reading Bible as Scripture, edited by Joel B. Green and David F. Watson, Baylor University Press, 2012. The first is Scripture as a Means of Grace, by Kenneth J. Collins. The second is Reading Scripture, the Literal Sense, and the Analogy of Faith by Robert W. Wall. And the third is by yours truly, and it's called Scripture is Canon. We hope you're enjoying these Plain Truth Shorts. The best way you could support our podcast is by leaving us a 5-star review on your favorite podcast provider. You can also like our page on Facebook and follow us on Twitter, where our handle is @HolySpiritPod. Thanks for listening, and we'll be back with more episodes soon.